Hello, welcome to the Night Save Lives channel. I'm here today to do a first impressions video of a clone. This is a Shirogorath clone. I got, thought it looked like a pretty nice design knife. Comes in a magnetic box. This one actually came with the credit card folding like knife. It's kind of cool. Here's the knife. I actually got this yesterday. And there was a few things I was looking for one day, about a month ago, a little over a month ago, trying to find a knife that met just a few simple requirements. First off, was a full flat ground blade. Secondly, I wanted titanium handles. I like them because they are light. Aluminum would be lighter, but I think titanium is a little nicer. And I was also looking for something with fairly decent ergonomics and a pocket clip. And surprisingly enough, to come across all those things together in one knife is a very rare thing. There are knives out there that people make that are like that. But in the production knife world, there really isn't a whole lot. And, in fact, the rounded handles, where they round it here, I don't know if I've ever actually seen that on one of these modern type folders ever. Usually if I have one that's rounded, it's because I rounded it. I have a Spyderco Southard, Brad Southard Flipper, and it actually is rounded on the lock side on the titanium part, but as they come out of the box, they're really square on the opposite, the show side, and I don't know, just doesn't look like it'd be very comfortable to me. Mine is, because it's been modified, but those key things that I was searching out for, I looked all over the place, and the other ones that I did find, unfortunately, there are already ones I have, like the Boker Titan Drop, or the Spyderco Native 5 with the titanium handles. And actually, it's not even rounded handles, but it's got almost everything I was looking for. And there's just not much of that out there. So this is what I went with. I literally looked through hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of models of all different brands, trying to find something to fit. And this was what I came across, and I thought, well, you know, $63 for that, I'll buy it. It might be good, might not be. Either way, it'll give me something to make a video on for the channel, and I can have a knife and see what I think about it. So I always like to experiment with different knives, different makers, different models. But, I got this in the mail yesterday. I opened it up, and I wasn't really expecting it to be a very good knife. I figured it would probably have, like, some slop in the closed position with the detent, or something like that, or, like, it would be incredibly difficult to open, or stiff. But this thing is pretty immaculate, actually. When I first opened it, I thought it was assisted opener. And I actually had to check it. I had to break the detent and to see if they actually had a spring that took over, because I literally thought it was an assisted opener. It came open so well. It does have a bearing system in it. There's a bearing on both sides of the blade, roller bearings, or the little ball bearing ones. Kind of looks like maybe a knockoff of the KVT bearing system. I'm not totally sure. Has the titanium pocket clip, which is indeed titanium. It is non-magnetic. I realize aluminum is non-magnetic too, but I'm pretty sure it's not aluminum. But it has a steel insert on top of the lock bar. And just like the Spyderco Tough, it also works secondarily as a over-travel stop. It has a pin behind the lock arm that extends down and butts up against the handle scale, preventing it from being overextended or hyperextended, however you want to call it. The flipper actually is nicely done. This knife, every single edge on this knife is knocked over. It's just completely nice as far as that goes. There's no sharp edges anywhere on the handle at all. I'm pretty impressed with that. There's a couple of drawbacks to its design. I'm not going to speak of the knives to which this is meant to copy, because I don't have one of those, so I wouldn't judge them as harshly, because I don't know if they actually have the same issues. But this one, as you can see, has much the same deal as I had with the Strider, also the ZT200, and the Spyderco Brad Southern Flipper all are able to be, you can grab the tip of the knife, and with the Strider I actually cut myself one day. I somehow got my finger up in there and it just slit me open pretty good, and I was pretty ticked off about that. But this over here, I can actually make contact with the very edge of the knife right here, and pretty full contact on that. So those are a couple of things that I would be concerned about as far as safety goes. Once you kind of look your knife over, if you have one that might have these issues, take note of that. That way, if you have it and you're using it, you know what to expect and what to watch out for. So that might save you some pain. But they have rounded everything. It's rounded all right here. It's rounded here. And I mean rounded, not just the edge broken. This is rounded, and this is too. It turns a little square down here and on both of these parts of the knife. But seems pretty good so far. The lock doesn't creak when I squeeze the knife in hand. It doesn't stick. I mean, it kind of has a little bit of stickiness to it. But it's not like anything that's difficult to open. But what really I thought was interesting was the cutout for the lock face on the tang in here is it's like mirror polished. And I thought that was pretty odd. So I used this for a little bit yesterday, actually quite a while in fact, probably nearly an hour, just doing food prep. And I was fixing a potato and ham soup with a lot of different kinds of vegetables. And so I used this to cut up everything, literally the ham, the bell peppers, the onions, the garlic, the carrots, the potatoes. I used it for all that stuff. And then I added corn to it. I opened a can of corn, and it skipped on the top of the can in like three spots. So I used this to cut those spots that had been skipped open, and did that well and with ease. Actually, it sliced right up into the can, up into the lip part on top of the lid around the rim, and I was pretty impressed by that, cutting it like that. And I figured since I had already dulled it that much and I'd ended up having to sharpen it again, I just figured for the second can I just cut the entire can open with it, and it did pretty well. And I think it's a pretty good functioning knife. It did not have any chipping out of the edge at all. This is supposed to be what they advertised as 8CR or 9CR 18 MOV, something like that. And so I guess it's a fairly simple steel, probably, I guess, from what I understand, it's around 440 stainless. So, I mean, it's, you know, if you're like a total steel snob, you would probably not really be so fond of this knife. I like knives that are easier to sharpen, honestly. I mean, I have knives that are in steels that are generally more wear-resistant and difficult to sharpen, but this is, you know, I'd like to find things like this more often from actual makers rather than people out there cloning knives. I would like to see, you know, the full flat ground blades, the rounded handle scales. I'd love to see a lot more of that. And One of the reasons why I wanted to go with full titanium handles, and a lot of people don't like full metal handles, but most plastics contain like BPA and stuff like that, which from what I understand mimics like estrogen in the body, and that it can lead to like kidney failure and cancer and liver failure and, you know, heart disease and all this other kind of stuff. And, you know, it might not seem that important to you, but for me, I have a knife in my pocket all hours of the day. Every single day, you know, I use a knife all the time. You know, it's something I use so often that I shouldn't be handling it if it's made out of a bunch of toxic materials. There are other materials besides just full metal handles that you could go with that would likely not contain such a substance as BPA or bisphenol or whatever they call it. Such as like wood or bone handles, rock, which to me seems like a really bad idea. If you drop the knife, you'll probably crack your nice stone handles, depending on what kind you use. I've always personally thought the malachite would be an extremely beautiful stone to have as a handle on a knife. Unfortunately, it is a very brittle stone. For those of you who don't know what malachite looks like, here's a piece. It is amazingly beautiful. And you can see all the segments in it. If I drop this, this thing would just break into a million pieces. But it has swirls in it, as though it was plantation, which I do actually believe, from what I understand, malachite is petrified herbivorous dinosaur shit. So, but it is probably my favorite stone material. Would be neat to see it on a knife. And if I had it on one, I would probably carry it and use it. Even though it'd be more of a display piece. But anyway, that aside, yeah, I don't know. It probably sounds like I'm going crazy or whatever, not wanting some BPA to be in my knife that I handle all hours of the day. So, but yeah, that's my preference. I'm not going to stop carrying knives with G10 handles and Micarta handles and stuff like that, or FRN handles. I like all those knives, but I just wanted something that would be a better everyday carry for me, you know. So, and if I hadn't mentioned it before, I do have a Chris Reeves Umnumzon StarTac model coming here pretty soon, and I will be doing a first impressions video on that. So look forward to that, and it will probably become my main carry for now, I think. It actually looks like a little overly heavy-duty knife for, like, probably the thickness behind the edge and stuff like that. And it being a hollow grind, I guess it's a fairly thick hollow grind, so I don't know. We'll see how that works out. Either way, it's about time I had one and, you know, did some impressions on it, maybe a review, so I hope you look forward to that. And anyway, yeah, and one thing I would like to also mention about these clone knives is I really don't condone buying them necessarily. I realize that I had bought one, but I have an insufferable addiction to knives, and it's just a fact. So I know I have a problem. And admitting it's the first step. But I'm never going to try to recover from that addiction, so don't worry about it. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you very much for watching, and leave some comments.